Nelson Mandela went to the stock exchange to assure investors he is committed to economic stability. Mandela is expected to sweep to power in the nation's first all-race elections. The South African military said it will deploy 100,000 troops and police to ensure a peaceful vote. South Africa is expecting a huge voter turnout next week. Only a few hard-line whites are planning to boycott the election. Most are willing to give democracy a chance. For encouragement, they can look to a neighboring nation that's made the transition to majority rule. Dan Rather reports from South Africa and Zimbabwe.
Across South Africa, many white citizens worry that the good life will turn bitter and more dangerous for them under black majority rule. For some, like the Walkden family, the fear has become too great.
Being exposed to it on a day-to-day basis, seemingly life is cheap and worth nothing.
They're moving to New Zealand.
What would you say to that family?
I would say no, have no cause for fear at all. Be at peace.
Robert Mugabe is president of Zimbabwe, South Africa's neighbor to the north, what used to be Rhodesia. 14 years ago, it was Zimbabwe that changed its government from white minority control to black majority rule.
There was a lot of disquiet, concern about having a new president.
David Hasluck was a farmer back then who joined other whites in a vicious war with the forces of Robert Mugabe, a declared Marxist-Maoist revolutionary.
Did you have fears for yourself and your family after the revolutionary forces won?
Yes, of course. There was great concern that there would be chaos and there was possibility of a bloodbath.
14 years later, Zimbabwe has seen neither bloodbath nor the promised revolution. The new black-run government focused not on retribution, but on improving the economy.
Zimbabwe's tremendous natural resources help fuel the economy. The magnificent scenery of Victoria Falls and abundant wildlife are major tourist attractions. And after mining and agriculture, tourism is Zimbabwe's biggest income earner.
Despite fears that the economy would falter, for most whites in Zimbabwe today, life couldn't be better.
Oh, yes, yes, I wouldn't be anywhere else in the world. The whites are here. They still are in control of the economy. They have most of the land in the country, they being commercial farmers.
For black Zimbabweans, the picture has been mixed. Some land has been redistributed to the poor, but for many blacks, life here is still close to the edge of desperation.
What has happened in Zimbabwe is this. Neither black hopes nor white fears have been fully realized. For blacks who were expecting, hoping for dramatic change, poverty remains a common experience.
We were thinking that it will be better, but it's getting worse.
I think it's a tragedy.
In a garden across town, Ian Smith, the last prime minister of old Rhodesia, is tolerated by the black government, even as he accuses it of communism and corruption.
Why do you stay?
Because it's my country. I was born here. My roots go down deep, and I love it.
Those who have stayed would tell their neighbors in South Africa how little has changed compared to how much more has stayed the same. Real change occurs across generations. The young now sing one common national anthem, and all now call themselves Zimbabweans.
In South Africa, the voting begins on Tuesday. CBS News will be there, and Dan will have another special report on Monday. Coming up next on the CBS Evening News,